In this video, we will talk about system for signaling and indications, and we will see how signal lamp from IFN can create these signals flexibly. So let's see why we need indication signal. Let's consider an example. We have a machine with an operator, and this machine has sensors inside it which are programmed to alert the operator in case of warnings or states of machine or emergency situations. So let's see typically why we need indication signal. The first reason is to know the current state of machines. Now, machine could be in different states. Let's see what are the different states which we need to know. The first one is non-fatal error or fault. We should know that, and this is generally indicated by a red light. The second state could be from the orange light, which could be manual or maintenance state. Or last, it could be a normal or run state. So these are the states which user needs to know so that he can make some decisions. The second reason is to alert the operator on warning conditions. Now, what could be the warning conditions? It could be insufficient raw material, which is maybe on the conveyor, or it could be less pneumatic pressure in the machine, or it could be empty magazines. So these indication signals are generally indicated by a blinking of the lights. The third reason could be to alert the operator on emergency conditions. Now, this is generally done by a buzzer. Now, the emergency conditions could be e-stop pressed by the operator or by a user, or it could be light curtains which are obstructed, because light curtains are generally used for safety purpose. Or it could be a process value which goes beyond critical range. It could be overpressure or over temperatures. So these are the three main reasons why we need indication signals. Next, we will see what could be indication signal. The first one could be for the light signals, it could be state of machines, and then we can have a blinking light signal for warning, and we can have a buzzer for emergency situations. All right, now we will see some standards in indication signals. Generally, having an indication signal is not okay unless we know the standards. So the first standard is luminance. The luminance of the light should be in such a way that there should be two levels. It should be too bright in right light condition so that user can see it, or it should not be too bright, it should be less bright in low light condition so that it does not affect the nearby indicating signals. The second standard is about the blinking and flashing. The blinking and flashing rate should be such a way that user can differentiate different blinking and flashing sequences. So there are slow, medium and fast. So generally in a machine, we use blinking for unacknowledging events or new errors. And generally we use flashing for normal transitory event, for example, filling of tank. Now third standard is for the audible range of your buzzer. Now the buzzer should be audible enough for the noisy environment, or it should not be too loud in the silent environments. So there should be a way to change the audible range or to change the blinking or the luminance of your light. So when you think about these three various devices, what could be an ideal device you can use in your machine so that you don't have to install so many devices? Don't worry, IFM has the solution. IFM brings you a lightweight smart device with 5 segments and inbuilt buzzer for signaling machine conditions. So let's see what are the key features of this device. The first key feature is it can be operated with DC voltage ranging from 18 to 30 volts. Secondly, it is programmable. You can program various colors, you can program their intensities, and you can also program the buzzer. Third is real-time change of parameter. Using a software named as LI device, you can change the parameter on the fly. Then it also supports high-speed IO-Link technology, by which if you already have IO-Link master, you can link your signal light directly to the next available ports. Next is it also supports Profinet, so it can read-write the signal with PLC at Profinet speed. Next is it has a built-in buzzer which is maximum 85 decibel audible range. So these are the key features which IFM brings you in a signal lamp, so you don't need multiple devices. There's a one device which has all these features. Now next is we will see some examples. The first example is how it is capable of generating different colors in a signal lamp. If you see this HMI screen, we have various bits defined for signal light segments. So in this signal lamp we have 5 segments. And we have specified bytes for these segments. And I have split these bytes into these bits. And here in this example, we will only see the color codes. So here, if this is 0, which means all bits are 0. In this green rectangle, the lights are off. You can see in signal lamp, there is no light, no segment is on. So in this segment, if I need blue light, I need 1 in this byte, which means my first bit should be true. So if I make it true, you will see that in my signal lamp, the blue light is on. Now in segment 2, I can also make it blue. Similarly in segment 3, 4 and 5. So our signal lamp is divided into 5 segments. There is also a possibility to change the color of the segment, for example green. For that, I will first reset these bits. So for the green light, I have a master button here which will set all these bits together. So here you can see that now my lamp is green. So if I need another color, let's say 4, which is for red, I can make all the segments red like this. So this is the simplest way to define the bits and energize it to change the color in the segment. So if you want to mix the colors, you can also do that. So in this case right now, it's 110, which is 6, so my color is amber or yellow. If I need white color, which is 111, I can set all these bits. Now I have white color. Or you can also mix the color like this. This is 5, which is purple. So this was the first example to see how we can change the colors in a signal lamp. I hope you find it quite flexible and easy. Isn't that amazing? So let's see the next example what signal lamp can do. Signal lamp is also capable of blinking or flashing the segment independently. So let's see that. Now in this example, we will see how we can blink or flash the colors. We have seen why we need blinking or flashing in the earlier slides. Now for example, if my segment 1 needs to be flashed or needs to be blinked, I have defined some codes here. And this orange area is defined for this part. Alright? So if it's 0, which means all the bits are false, this is stable, which means it will not blink. If I want to blink it slowly, I will just energize this bit. On energizing this bit, you will see my signal lamp that my segment 1 is blinking slowly. If I want medium blinking, I can try on segment 2. For that, I have to set 2, which is 10 in binary. Okay? So here you can see that the segment 2 is blinking with the medium frequency. If I have to make it blink faster, I have to move 3. So let's try for segment 3. Now here you can see that it is blinking at higher frequency. Alright, so now if I want to make it flash but not blink, I have to move 4, 5 or 6. So in this case, let's try on segment 4. So right now you can see in my signal lamp that segment 4 is flashing slowly. Now if I want to make it flash at medium frequency, I have to move 5. Now you see segment 4 is flashing at medium frequency. Okay. Now if I want to make it flash fast, I have to move 6. So let's try on segment 5. So you can see segment 5 is now flashing at maximum frequency. Now to differentiate fast flashing, let me turn off blinking for other segments so that you can notice the difference. Now when it's 4, it's flashing slowly. Now this is at 4. And now for medium frequency, it should be 5. This is medium. And to make it flash fast, it should be 6. Alright, so this is how you can set the blinking or flashing frequency in your signal lamp. And I can also show you how you can also blink or flash the segments all together. So this was the second example showing how we can blink or flash the segment quite flexibly and easily using IFM signal lamp. So not only this, let's see what else we can do with the signal lamp. In this example, we'll see how it is capable of generating various buzzer sounds for warning. Signal lamp also has inbuilt buzzer inside it, which we can also use along with blinking. So there is a specified byte for the buzzer. Here we have 3 bits which define the mode of the buzzer. And 1 bit, bit 0, is used to enable the buzzer. So first we will enable the buzzer. And now in our lamp you can see red light in segment 1 and 2 is blinking already. If you want to generate a buzzer sound along with this red light blinking, which might be assigned to a specific error, we can energize the buzzer. Now there are 7 buzzer modes in this signal lamp. You can define the meaning of each buzzer in your manuals. So now we will see the buzzer mode one by one to show you how it makes various sounds. Alright, so let's start with the first one. So this is a simple buzzer. Alright, now let's move to the second example. This is for buzzer 2, that's for buzzer 3, and then we will go for buzzer 4. Now we will see buzzer 5. This is the fifth mode, and then we'll see buzzer 6. This is buzzer 6. And then in the end we have the seventh buzzer. So There are 7 different buzzers here we have in our signal lab. Right? And you can disable the buzzer from here.
So if the buzzer is disabled, these modes will not make any sound. So you have seen now how simple it is to actuate different colors in the segment, make it blink or flash or make buzzer sound to alert the user using IFM signal lamp. So these were the 3 basic features what signal lamp can do. Now comes the most interesting feature of signal lamp. You can also change the parameter of the signal lamp on the fly using LR device software, which is available by IFM. This will help you to quickly and easily change the parameters. But when you change the parameters, you can have some amazing results. So let's see some example of what LR device software is capable of doing with signal lamp. The first example it shows, signal lamp is capable of changing intensity of segment in real time. So let's see that. There is also a possibility to change the luminosity of the lamp, which can be done by LR device software provided by the IFM. You can see here we can change the intensity of all the segments. The default value is 75%, the minimum is 0%, and the maximum value we can put is 100%. So currently the intensity of the light for all the segments are set at 75%. If you want to make it 100%, let's try changing the intensity. So after changing to 100%, you just have to write the change in your device. So now I just have to write the value from this icon. In fraction of seconds, you will see the intensity of the light changes to 100%. So the intensity is changed while the signal light was operating. I don't have to stop it. This is one of the key advantages of using signal lamp from IFM. Now if your signal lamp is installed in dark environment, we do not need 100%. So let's change it to 10%. Now you see the light luminosity at 10% intensity. So this is the flexible way to change the luminosity or intensity of various segments of signal lamp from 0 to 100% based on environment conditions. Let's change it back to 75%. So not only this, now let's see what else we can do with LR device. In this example, we will see how signal lamp is capable of changing intensity of buzzer in real time. Now in the same software, LR device, I can also change the buzzer intensity. Currently, you can see that it is set at 2%. So let's hear the volume of buzzer when it is set at 2%.
Okay, now the buzzer is going on. And while the buzzer is running, I'm going to increase its intensity to 4%. And let's see the difference. So you can see that the volume has been increased.
Now let's see the last feature, what we can do with signal lamp. Now, signal lamp is also capable of generating animation based on process value. Isn't that amazing? So let's see how we can do that. In this example, you will see how we can animate analog values on signal light. For example, currently you will see the process value is 50%. And here we have various modes of operation for the animation. For example, if it is 0, all the bits are off and signal light will not show anything. Let's select the first mode, which says background off, indicator white, bottom to top. So I'm going to select the first mode. Now in the first mode, you will notice that at 50%, we have 3 segments on from bottom to top. So the analog range of 100% is divided into 5 segments of 20% each. That's why at 50%, we have 3 segments on. Now let's change the process value to 0%. At 0%, we have only 1 segment on. And from 0 to 19%, we have 1 segment always energized. The moment process value increases to 20%, we have the next segment on. Similarly, if the process value increases to 90%, we have all the segments on. So this was mode 1 behavior. If you want to see opposite behavior, for that we have mode 2. In this mode, the animation will reverse. It will now animate from top to bottom. Now if the process value changes to 10%, you will notice that in this case, the top segment is on. This is the opposite. As the process value increases, the light will animate from top to bottom. Alright, now if you want to see more animation with different colors, we can select other modes. For example, let's select mode 5, background green, indicator blue, bottom to top. So for 5, binary is 101. Now this is mode 5, you can see that in my signal lamp, indicator is blue and background is green. As the process value decreases, the blue indicator will also move down proportionally. Alright, Now we can also select different colors if you want. For example, background red, indicator blue, that is mode 6. So here you can see the behavior of lamp in mode 6 with background red and indicator blue from bottom to top. So these were various modes of operation. Sometimes we may want our extreme limits to blink. For example, if you see in mode 4, background is off, indicator is white, top to bottom, blink at 0 and 100%. So now, let's see the blinking of segment in mode 4. We will see the behavior when the process value is 0%. Now you will notice in the signal lamp that the top segment is blinking. Now this is from top to bottom. If you want to see from bottom to top, we should change the mode. So let's change the mode to mode 3. Now you will notice the bottom segment is blinking. This blinking can be used to indicate critically low level. So when the process value increases, let's say 10%, it will stop blinking. If process value decreases a little bit, let's say 9%, it will still remain stable. Bottom segment will only blink at 0%. Alright? Now if my value is 99%, you will see that all the segments are on. And top segment will only blink at 100%, which may be used to indicate that level is critically high. So we have seen the various features of signal lamp using different examples. Now let's see, to program the signal lamp, what do you need? The first device you need is an IO-Link master. This is a device which will communicate with your IO-Link devices, which is a signal lamp. Now in this device, you also need a 24-volt power supply to power up your devices. And of course, you need a controller, for example PLC, to program your IO-Link devices. And you need a signal lamp which can be connected to any of these available ports. And there is an optional software error device which you can use to change the parameters. I highly recommend you to have the software. So these are the various key features and how quickly you can change the indication light based on your requirement. So what are you waiting for? Install signal lamp and make monitoring smart and flexible. If you want to buy your own signal lamp, you can visit this link. This link is also given in the description. If you like this video, you can subscribe to this channel to watch more videos on IFM sensors and actuators exclusively on this channel. Thank you for watching.